Welcome back to my channel, friends. This side Sonia here, and today I am going to do some decoupage work on this very, very sturdy and handy canvas tote bag. And this one has a really good space, which is just perfect for any of your use. You can use it with your casual dressing or for your regular stuff. And I thought I will do some decoupage technique. Now I was really confused on which tissues to use, because Nagashi Arts has such amazing collection of tissues that I got confused. So I thought, let me just put some on my bag and then see what works well for this one. So here I think I will go with something which is similar of this color, but then like I said again, it's really confusing, so I was not sure, because they have some really amazing design and it's very confusing. I am liking this sunflower design. Maybe I can have this one as a centerpiece, or maybe I can have like I said, this is really confusing. Or can I have this one? I'm not sure. See, that's the problem when you have so many amazing designs. And yes, Nagashri always sends me such amazing tissues that I actually get confused while making my projects. So, but it's a good confusion to have. Okay. Or maybe I can have this one. I think I will go with this pretty girl. I really like this one, and it's the proper white. I was looking for something in off-white, but I guess I can manage with this, and this will look fab. I just love this pretty girl. And let me see how it, oh, this one is going to look just so pretty. Okay, so I'm going to start with this one. So here I'm going to cut my extra paper, and I am just going to have this girl design. I'm even going to chuck this one for the time being. Let me see how it looks. So I've taken a paintbrush and my water jug, and I'm just going to tear off the extra side parts. This is such a fun way. I love decoupage, and this is one of the reasons why I really love decoupage, because it actually, I feel it's a very big stress buster, and it's fun. The best part is that it's really fun to play with colors and your Mod Podge and this beautiful decoupage tissues. So it's always something crazy what you can create and use, and that's the best part of it. Usually with many of the craftings, it's just like you make it and then you really don't know what to do with that. But see, with the cushion covers, the bags, the organizers, the MDF stuff, you really know that you can use it in some or the other way, and that's the one of the fun part of doing decoupage. So here I'm just removing all the excessive layers, the designs, and I'm going to make sure that I remove this straight line from my sheet because I really don't want that. And here is my design, and this looks pretty. Now I'm going to remove all the plies. Here is my So here is my first ply. You need to be a little careful with the delicate designs. And now I need to remove my second ply also. Oops. I'm just searching for an easy way from where I can pull off the second ply. This is the best area. Yay, I could remove it, and I'm done with removing my second ply also. Now here is my bag, and this pretty girl is ready. Now I am going to have my matte finish Mod Podge. I need to zoom out a little so that I can show you that how I placed it. So it's almost at the center of this bag. Now, just for precaution, I'm going to keep an extra waste backing inside just to make sure that I don't stick my Mod Podge. It will not run through, but still just for the precaution. And I'm going to make sure that I have a plastic sheet so that I can stick it. Now, with my flat brush, I'm going to apply a coat of Mod Podge. Now I know that I will be needing Mod Podge in this much area, so I'm going to do my Mod Podge here. And you need to make sure that you apply your Mod Podge really well, because like I always say, Mod Podge is something which is going to stick your decoupage tissue or your papers really well to your project. So you need to make sure that you apply your Mod Podge really well, and it has to be in a good quantity because you need to stick it well. Otherwise, what's the use of doing your project? Okay, so here this looks good. Maybe I need to add some more here and some more here just to make sure that my Mod Podge has applied properly. And now I'm going to stick this one with the help of this plastic sheet. Now what happens when you stick your project with the plastic sheet, it becomes really easy to press it. You don't have to press it really hard, just dab it. Dabbing becomes super easy, and you can always press as required, and with your fingers you can easily dab this, and this makes your work pretty easy. And it's done, and it's looking just awesome. And I must tell you, it's all because of this pretty girl who is looking super cute on this canvas bag. So now I let it dry, and I'll be back when this is dried out completely so that I apply Now I need to apply a layer of Mod Podge on the top of it just as a sealer, but I am going to be very sure that I need to press it really really slowly because it's still wet. I'm done with my decoupage work and it's time to add some more twist and drama to it. So here I'm going to have my nice dangler and I wanted to create this. So I have these net pieces and I thought I'll make some bow with these. So I am just going to assemble this quickly and I need to tie a knot. I can use my glue gun for this, but I already have some extra pieces of net, so I'm going to use this on my bow to tie it up. I don't want it to change the size or the wrinkles what I have created, the falls basically. So yeah, okay, now with one knot my pretty bow flower is ready and I'm going to create one more with this. It's pretty easy. Take a long piece of net and just crumble it like the way I have done and tie it with any of your favorite color or a contrast color also. You can pick some nice contrast thread or lace and it's ready. Okay, so now here I'm done. I'm just tying a one knot because here I already have my glue gun and I have decided to use these bow on my thread and I'm going to stick it with my glue gun. So here what I'm going to do is, okay, one more thing. I'm also going to add these pretty beads. These are called sentiment tiles and I have so many and I thought I'll choose some generic ones. See, this cute friend and cute, imagine and free. I'll use these three beads and I'm going to use this on my thread. Cute, imagine, free and leaf. Maybe I'll use these four sentiment tiles. Imagine, leaf, free, cute. Now I'm going to use these on my thread. So first I need to decide the length, like what length of jute thread I want for this project. So maybe I can have dangler of say, I don't want it too big, so of this size. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut this. Then I also need to decide of which size length I want these hangings to be. So I'm going to keep all the four of different size. And I think I'll make one more a little longer. Four. Okay, so here I'm done with this. Now I'm going to have my jute thread. Okay, maybe I need to take some fevicol, just seal the edges and then pull it inside. So, okay, I can give a nice knot here so that it has a good end and it doesn't come out at all. And this works great and it's looking super cute. So now my cute is done. Then it's time to have my another bead. Now with these beads you have two different sentiments. One is imagine, one is freedom. So yes, you will have too many things on your palette. I'll give a knot to this one also. You just need to make sure that you tie this knot really well, because this is something which is going to keep your sentiment tile in place. Now for the third one. Now having a liquid adhesive on your tip really makes your work easy to put your threads inside your beads. So it's a quick tip. I have been doing this since long and it's super easy when you are working with very micro and mini beads and you want to have something nice and colorful thread on it, but it's difficult to how to put it inside. This one does not need any adhesive, so I can easily poke this inside. And I am almost done. So this was super easy. I'm not going for a very janky panky thing, cause this design is just a sober, just a pretty one, and I want to keep it as it is. So here my pretty beads are ready, and now I'm going to tie this on this single thread. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have this, give it a good tie, and I'm going to give it a good small tiny knot. Okay, so this is done, and now to seal this I'm going to use my glue gun. I had already put on my glue gun to hot, and it's really hot now this is going to be my sealer, and I am going to tie a knot here. I just want to make sure that this is dried. I don't want to burn my fingers for sure, or maybe I can just have a good glue gun here, and this has sticked well. Okay, now oops. This is done, and now quickly I need to tie this on my bag, and so that I can use and stick my net flowers. So I'm just going to wrap this inside, and this is how it is going to be. And I'm going to make sure that I also add some glue here. And now here I am going to stick my net flower. And my beautiful hanging is ready. I just thought I should add some more here so that it adds a little more popping up thing. So I'll add my glue gun, and I'm going to stick it at the center. And I also have one more small piece. I'll add this also, but you need to make sure that you press it really well so that it sticks well to your dangler base. And it is done. Okay, ta-da! Now my dangler is ready. I have pressed it really well and it is looking super cute. Now with this, my video tutorial is done. I hope you liked this video, and I hope you'll be making one soon for you. I have listed all the supplies down in the description box. Do check that. And yes, do not forget to subscribe to my channel. And thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.